just like Larry spent a lot of time with lawyers, and he's somewhat pessimistic about them. I spent a lot of time with capitalists, having been through about one cycle of venture capital, and I'm very pessimistic about capitalists. I mean, I thought that the panel earlier with the venture capitalists was very interesting, the world without exits, but they all kind of agree, right? And one of the problems with when you involve money in anything, even if it's hybrid, is money tends to have a very basic, fundamental, rather short-term, stupid sort of parameter. I mean, my Chinese roommate's father said, money is very easy, it's lonely. It always goes where other money is. You know? And money tends to be fairly short-sighted, and the problem is when you connect money with the internet, which is very efficient, you get fluctuation amplification, right? So whether it's the mortgages or whether it's global markets, you get these huge waves, right? And the problem is that most of the people involved in money right now, whether it's venture capitalists or investment bankers, they are still working on trying to make things faster and more efficient, which just makes the amplification worse, right? And when you talk about long-term things like the commons and the world and all that, the capitalists aren't really that helpful generally, unless they have foundations. And some people feel that, so they're like Soros would set up a foundation to try to dampen some of this amplification. But my fear, and also my hope, is that these hybrid models, the worst case scenario is when the venture capitalist infects a hybrid model with a short-term business thing. And as a public company, Google also suffers from this, because they have this don't be evil, we must be open, but then they've got these quarterly shareholders who press on them for certain kinds of things. It's very difficult to keep the commons alive while still preserving shareholder value in the typical sense of the word, right? And so I think that the answer to this is to try to infect capitalism with the somewhat longer-term commons-oriented stuff in the sharing economy. But if it doesn't work properly, it would go the other way. And can I make my comment about mobile devices? Yeah. I mean, so the one example that I have is I see this full-on march towards mobile, as if it were the next holy grail, this is where the money is, all the VCs are going, but they really haven't thought about the repercussions of what happens. So in Japan, we have more than half of the internet on mobile. This is just a really basic example. And when you give money to the current fixed-line internet, a lot of that money goes back into the economy because it's so low-priced. You know, although people argue about how much money Google gives back in traffic acquisition, it's still billions of dollars, goes back into startup and venture-funded companies. There's a whole ecology, right? Well, when you pay, so in Japan mobile, you know, you had 300 million or so in mobile ads. You know, you have 4 or 5 billion in content, which is just crap, download, just ringtone stuff, and then rest is just another 4 or 5 billion in transactions. Most of the money ends up with the carrier, who pay bloated R&D labs, and pay vendors who have bloated R&D labs, and spectrum that's controlled by the government. So you've got the special interests that Larry's talking about, you've got bloated R&D labs, and none of the money going back into startups. And are we really interested in funding a whole bunch of companies that are just gonna pour consumer money into these carriers before we unlock it? Because what we're doing is we forget that we had to fight to create this open internet, and then we're taking where the money is, the users and the content, and we're saying, hey, let's plop it onto a platform that's not open. And you know, what are we going to do? Hope for the best. And the problem is, venture capitalists aren't incented and don't have the habit of thinking about those kinds of repercussions. I mean, they don't have the habit of thinking about ICANN or who are the root server operators, all these volunteers who make the trains run on time. They assume that the internet just works, right? And that's really irresponsible, and it's very typically capitalist. And so one of the things, I don't want to be branded a communist or anything like that, but what's although I will be.
You're a venture communist.
A venture communist, right. But I think, you know, as we're talking about all these being, you know, ecologically sound companies and all this sort of grid, all this stuff, we really need to think of the internet as an environment that we need to protect. And if we want to continue to make money on the internet, we need to think about hybrids, we need to think about how do we preserve this kind of openness, and it isn't just about running around chasing deals.